33, we're going to be using properties of exponents. Very important topic, obviously. We use them again and again and again. And again, there's those three properties. Addition, or but this is going backwards. We've got it in a single logarithm, but we're going to write it as multiple logarithms. And it does say we should not have radicals or exponents. So we're going to use that exponent rule. So remember, go back, I think, what was it, 31, if you want to formalize each of the logarithms. This is a log base 10. So let's just write that real quick. So, and I'll write it sort of in this way. So if I have a log of x times y, when I go to expand it, that's going to be log of x plus log of y. If I have log of x divided by y, then that property tells us we end up with log of x minus log of y. So that anything in the denominator always ends up being negative. And then finally, if I have the log of some exponent, and let me do this with a square root because we do have a square root. So say the square root of x. What I want to do is, the square root is a half power. So this is going to be the log of x to the 1/2 power. But I'm not done yet. I need this exponent to become multiplication in front. So the full expansion would be 1/2 log x, okay? And again, if I had log x to the third, the 3 comes down in front and I end up with 3 times log x. So let's walk through this. So we start with this. I can see, okay, so anything that's multiplication in the top, I've got this 4 times this, so that's a multiplication, that's going to be addition, and I'm dividing by this part here. So I'm going to just make this into 3 parts. I think this is, to me, the easiest way to sort of do it. Anything that's multiplication in the top becomes addition. So that's the log of 4 plus the log of x plus 6 raised to the 5th minus the log of square root of x to the 3rd. So that's sort of the first round. Anything multiplied. Now, if I was multiplying something in the denominator, I've had these, they would both be subtracted. And again, you can think it's going to, I think we might see one of those. So, but we're not done yet. I need to get these exponents. So the next step is to bring the exponents down in front. So this 5 is going to go here. Log 4 is done. There's nothing more to do there. This one, just bring the exponent down. This part here, what we want to do is this square root is a 1/2 power. So I want to think of that as x to the 3rd times 1/2, which gives us x to the 3/2. And then again, that exponent goes down in front of the logarithm. It was still negative, but this 3/2 comes over here. So now what I'm going to have, I'll write this out, it's log base 4, that didn't change. This 5 comes down in front, so that's going to be 5 log of x plus 6. Now there is no rule of if I've got something in a logarithm that's addition, I can't, so this part now is done. I can't do anything with x plus 6, it stays there. And then I've got this minus, remember the exponent's going to be 3/2. So that's how a radical is a fractional exponent. And what's left inside here is just log of x. 4 there. And that's our final answer for that one. And again, be very careful with each of the things here. Alex is very critical on how he counts things. So this is log base 4. And then I do plus 5. Click on the log x plus 6. You might be able to get away without putting the parentheses. I'm going to go ahead and do that. I feel safer. And then we're going to minus 3/2. So let's put that in first. 3/2 times. So that's this expanded out, dealing with all of those. Thank you.